For numbers that matter, something on World Press Freedom Day. The United Nations says 70% of environmental journalists across the globe report to experiencing attacks, threats, or pressure related to the job. That's 749 media men from the years 2009 to 2023. The UNESCO report released today also showed 2 out of 5 environmental journalists have experienced physical violence. The UNESCO study of 900 reporters in 129 countries warned of rising cases of violence and intimidation against journalists in the environment and climate beat. The head of UNESCO says World Press Freedom Day should remind the international community to defend freedom of expression and protect journalists worldwide. Perhaps the only silver lining amid the searing heat in the Philippines is the discovery of the ruins of a centuries-old town in Nueva Ecija. Parts of the church and foundations of old structures from the old Pantabangan town resurfaced in recent weeks due to receding water levels in the town's dam. According to the local government, the old town was relocated in the 1970s when the dam was constructed. Pantabangan has seen a boom in tourism because of the phenomenon.
Nung nalaman ko na yung sabi na mayroong simbahan o bayan na lumang bayan na lumubog dito nga sa Pantabangan. Parang na-excite ako, gusto kong makita. Kaya sumama ako dito. Kaya nakita ko to, ito pala yun. Sabi ko, wow. Hindi ko alam na mayroong ganito dito.
Elementary pa lang po ako dito na nangingisda na po ako. Hanap buhay ka na po yan. Tapos yan pong simbahan po na yan, bali 3 beses ko pa lang po siya nakita na ganyan po. 2014, 20, tsaka 2024 po. Sa ano po, pangingisda ko po, 200 lang po yung kinikita ko. Pero po nung dumagsa po yung turista po na gusto po nilang makita yung simbahan, kumikita po ako ngayon ng 1,500, 1,800. Per day po.
Philippine businesses also urge to inspire trust in AI among consumers. Global consulting firm Boston Consulting Group made that call after finding in a study nearly half of consumers in the world are more excited than concerned about the rise of Gen AI. The firm says in order for this excitement to translate into demand, companies should come up with measures aimed at showcasing the reliability of AI as they integrate the technology into their systems and operations.
Businesses need solutions that are at scale, that are products that consumers can apply, and applications that they can implement. And I don't think we are there yet. If you look at Philippines as an example, there is a range of business maturity of Philippine businesses thinking about Gen AI. A few sort of early movers like GCash have started to apply advanced AI models in their data programs, etc. And so they are ahead of the curve. But you can't say that about all companies are slowly climbing up that curve. One, businesses need to have a way to inspire trust with mm-hmm. their customers. Yeah. You cannot overstate the possibilities without explaining the risks. And you have to give that balanced narrative between the positives of this technology in terms of access and quality of service.